Hello friends, I am Dr. S.B. Kole, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannad, District Aurangabad. Today we will discuss solution of second order differential equation. Solution of second order differential equation with constant coefficient. Now first, A, homogeneous second order linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Take equation d2y by dx square plus a1 dy by dx plus a2y is equal to 0. D operator is equal to d dx. So, using this d operator, equation becomes d square plus a1d plus a2 bracket complete y is equal to 0. Auxiliary equation. So, d square plus a1d plus a2 is equal to 0. So, f of d is 0, equation second, which is quadratic equation in d, roots of which can be real and unequal or complex. First, if roots are real and distinct, if m1 and m2 are real and distinct roots of general solution of equation first, we get y is equal to c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x. Now, second, if roots are real and equal. Let us consider auxiliary equation having two equal roots, m1, m2 is equal to m. So, d minus m, second bracket d minus m, y is equal to 0. So, in first bracket d minus m, outside bracket y is equal to v. D minus m, outside bracket v is equal to 0. So, dv by dx minus mv is equal to 0. So, v is equal to a e raised to mx, d minus m, y is equal to a e raised to mx. Solution is y e raised to minus mx is equal to integration of e raised to minus mx, a e raised to mx dx is equal to a dx. Because here e raised to minus mx into e raised to mx get means cancelled. Because e raised to 0 and it is 1. So, only integration a dx remaining. So, y e raised to minus mx is equal to integration of a dx is equal to ax plus b. Because a is constant and integration of dx is x. So, ax plus b, b is constant. So, y is equal to ax plus b outside bracket e raised to mx. Now, third, if roots are in complex conjugate. Roots are alpha plus or minus I beta. Unequal roots and hence solution of the equation first. Y is equal to c1 e raised to alpha plus I beta outside bracket x plus c2 e raised to in bracket alpha minus I beta outside bracket x. Y is equal to e raised to alpha x. c1 e raised to I beta x plus c2 e raised to minus I beta x bracket complete. So, y is equal to e raised to alpha x in bracket c1 plus c2 cos beta x plus I c1 minus c2 sin beta x bracket complete. So, y is equal to e raised to alpha x in bracket a cos beta x plus I beta sin x sin beta x ib sin beta x. B, inhomogeneous second order linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Second order inhomogeneous linear differential equation with constant coefficient is given by d2y by dx square plus p dy by dx plus qy is equal to x. Equation first. So, y double dash plus a1 y dash plus a2 y is equal to x. Equation second. Solution of equation consists of two parts, complementary function and particular integral. To get cf, we solve auxiliary equation d square plus a1 d plus a2 is equal to 0. F of d is equal to 0, equation 3. Now, pi is y is equal to x upon f of d. Let us assume that roots of auxiliary equation 3 are m1 and m2. F of d is equal to d minus m1 in second bracket d minus m2, equation 4. Cf is given by y is equal to c1 e raised to alpha plus under root beta outside bracket x plus c2 e raised to alpha minus under root beta outside bracket x. Pi is equal to x upon d minus m1 in second bracket d minus m2. So in bracket 1 upon d minus m1 outside bracket x is equal to v. X is equal to v d minus m1 in bracket. So dv by dx minus m1v is equal to x. This is first order differential equation. So v is equal to e raised to m1x integration of x e raised to minus m1x dx is equal to is equation 5. Solution of this equation is x upon d minus m1 is equal to e raised to m1x integration x e raised to minus m1x dx equation 6. So pi is 1 upon d minus m1 in bracket e raised to m1x integration x into e raised to minus m1x dx bracket complete. Now we will see special cases to find pi. Now first a case, right hand side is exponential. If we take x is equal to e raised to cx, so d is equal to c e raised to cx. D square c e raised to cx is c square e raised to cx, equation 7. Suppose roots of the equation d square a1d plus a1d plus a2 f of d is 0 are m1 and m2. So that c is not equal to m1 and c is not equal to m2. Using equation 7, in y dash plus a1y dash plus a2y is equal to x, f of d raised to cx is equal to c square plus a1c plus a2 is e raised to cx is equal to f of c e raised to cx. Now e raised to cx is equal to 1 upon f of d in bracket f of c e raised to cx. Now e raised to cx is equal to f of c into 1 upon f of d into bracket e raised to cx. E raised to cx 1 upon f of c is equal to 1 upon f of d into bracket e raised to cx, equation 8. Equation 8 does not hold good when f of c is 0, that is when c is equal to m1 or m2. In case c is equal to m1, f of d is equal to d minus c phi of d. 1 upon f of d e raised to cx is equal to e raised to cx upon d minus c phi of d. 1 upon f of d e raised to cx is equal to 1 upon d minus c in bracket e raised to cx upon phi of d. 1 upon f of d e raised to cx is equal to 1 upon d minus c into e raised to cx upon phi of c. 1 upon f of d e raised to cx is equal to in bracket 1 upon phi of c outside bracket e raised to cx integration of dx. 1 upon f of d e raised to cx is equal to in bracket 1 upon phi of c outside bracket x e raised to cx. Pi is of form kx e raised to cx. K is equal to 1 upon phi of c. Now take b. Function x raised to mx for m greater than 0 on right hand side. When x is equal to x of m, pi becomes y is equal to x raised to m f of d is equal to f of d inverse x raised to m. By expanding f of d inverse binomially in ascending order of d up to m. This is the reference I used for this presentation. Thank you.